Hello guys, welcome to my first episode of Vintage Tech. Let's get straight to it. Last week, I got a chance to check out my dad's room, where I found photos of three beauties. Three beauties which can take photos. Let's welcome the three beauties here. Meanwhile, I'll close my laptop and keep it aside. We need not go and bring the box. It'll come here with the magic of editing. Seems to be some technical issue. Wow! In the box, there are two SLRs and one Polaroid. SLR stands for single lens reflex, while D in front of DSLR stands for digital, as you already know. Both uses a single reflex mirror that allows the user to see what the lens sees and will be captured through the optical viewfinder. In addition, most of the DSLRs will be having a LCD screen to display the to-be-captured image. Another huge difference is the storage. SLRs use film rolls to capture images, while DSLRs uses today's fancy flash storage. Here comes the most significant difference. SLRs simply cannot shoot a video. Let me know if you would like to see a complete video on the difference and functionalities between SLR and DSLR. Okay, let's check what's the first camera here. Wow, see this cute little puppy. Can you see this? This is Chinon TM4S SLR. Oops. My bad. Chinon was a Japanese camera manufacturer. Kodak took over majority of Chinon in 1997. This particular Chinon camera is very heavy and it has a 1.9 50mm prime lens, which is also heavy. Obviously, there is no autofocus and no rear screen. Coming over to the top, it has a rotary knob to release the rear film compartment. A huge hot shoe for mounting lens and mic in the middle, a manual ring to change the shutter speed, followed by a shutter key and a short trigger button. You can also see a small display in the right side that is for number of shots remaining. Let's see how to click a photo on this machine. Just pull the knob and the rear portion of the camera will get opened. First, you need to load the film onto the camera. Once we close this compartment, we can check the count of number of shots which this particular film is able to take. Adjust the aperture and focus manually through the dials in the lens. And adjust the shutter speed with this dial. When you are ready, move the film exactly to the position where our shot needs to be captured. Just give a complete rotation of this shutter trigger and then click the shutter button. As simple as that. You can also keep the film ready by locking the film onto the position after each and every shot, so that we can save some more time while capturing the timely moment. We can shoot a maximum of 36 shots depending on the film roll's capacity. Not anywhere near the thousands of shots which we are taking today. Just think, how do people frame their shots then? There is no burst mode. But there is an automatic timer mode for selfies on those days. People use it mostly for group photos. I also have this camera flash with me, which supports removable batteries and manual brightness control. Next comes the covered camera. Let's open this cover up first. This camera is Ricoh KR10 Super. One second. Ok, Ricoh. Ricoh is a Japanese multinational imaging and electronics company. There is no much difference between the functionality of the Chinon camera and this one. But this one is slightly advanced and very easy to operate. Check this out. This is a brand new zoom lens which I got along with this Ricoh camera. I'm not sure how it's looking new. As you can see, it is an interchangeable lens camera, but mounting and unmounting is a real pain in the ass. The final camera is Polaroid 635CL. Polaroid is an American company that brand licenses and markets a portfolio of consumer electronics to companies that distribute consumer electronics and eyewear. It is best known for its Polaroid instant film and cameras. It was founded in 1937 by Land. This is an instant camera where you pick the picture and you get to see the images in seconds after printing it. The functionality behind capturing the photo and imprinting onto the Polaroid film involves a lot of chemistry. I am working on a separate video for that. Kindly be subscribed. You would have seen Polaroid filters on Instagram, and all photos taken by this camera will be applied with that filter. And note that we cannot undo it. Taking a photo is very easy. Insert the film, click and print. It also has a built-in flash, which can be charged with a battery. Note that Fuji is currently selling an instant camera in the market. And even Polaroid films are available now. I wasn't even born when these cameras got manufactured. All these three cameras were imported from Germany during the late 70s and early 80s. There were no domestic imports at the time. People those times would have definitely missed you, Amazon. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments if you like more vintage videos like this. Catch you guys in the next video.